Hi guys, and thanks for watching again. In this video I will be building this MP3 player, or what's it called, a DMP1 if I'm not mistaken. It's a very cheap MP3 player, and building this is not very hard if you know how to solder SMD components, but it will be a challenge because there is no manual whatsoever, no indication of which resistor or capacitor or diode goes where, except for this IC, which is fairly easy to guess. And I have a bunch of sticking resistors, capacitors over here without markings. Well, there are markings, 106p. Okay, so these are easy, but all the others I will have to find out which goes where. Now, I found a schematic on AliExpress, not eBay, where I bought this, and it is a schema of this circuit board, so I will have to trace back to see which goes where, and I will try to fix it like that. So let's get to it. So let's start with the IC, which is probably the easiest to do. Where's the sticky tape? Over here. It's probably mounted in, that's not mounted, it is placed in the correct position. There's a dot on the top right, and there's an indent in the marking below. So this is the correct position. Get this stuff off. Now, what I'm going to do, I'm going to move my camera to my desk with this unit, this very ugly tripod-ish thing, so you can actually see what I'm doing, because I'm mounting all SMD components. So there we go. Now, I've placed the camera in such a way that this power up from this old computer game is the exact center, exact for how exact it can get. Is the center for my workspace. So there we go. Let's first mount this IC over here. Double check the polarity. The dot is over there. The indent is over there. And I took this 0.6 millimeter solder wire. So I'm soldering the pad first. Flow a bit of solder on there. And then reflow it as soon as my IC is in position, and it is not exactly centered with from the look of the pad, so I'm gonna move it a little bit. That was a bit too much, and now it is not. That's better. That's how I like it. So let's see what I can do with all the other pins. There we go. So, the IC is done. This does not look good. It's burnt sticky stuff from the tape, probably. Let me get that out there. There we go. And now this joint looks horrible, so I'm going to reflow a little bit of solder on there. Now it looks like I have shorted both pins, but I have not. It is looking good. Alright, so now what I'm going to do, I'm going to find that image on my computer screen, and I'm going to start on the top right, R8, resistor number 8, and I'm going to trace it all the way. I'm going to try to mount the image in the video. Not sure if that will work. If it works, you'll see it right now. Now this is the image, and as you can see, there are resistor markings all over the image, and R8 is in the middle, and the value is below the resistor, and for R7, and I have 4 R7 resistors over here. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to find the 4 R7 resistor and mount it in place. There we go. And these are the 4 R7 resistors. They strip with the longest, the most resistors on there. So let me get first the 4 R7 resistor out. It is over here. Let me grab that. Awful. Now it is not cooperating. Try that again. That's better. So R8 in place. Let's do the second one. R7. Currently looking at the image, and R7 is on the top in the middle. You can wind back to the position in the video if you want to look at it. And it says 2R2, and I believe I have seen that before. Let me get a little bit of light. And I believe I only need one, and they provided some spares. Or for the learning area, as they call the outside, 6 outside resistors. So if this kit would contain a manual, it would be a perfect learning kit for soldering SMD components, because it contains one IC, loads of resistors and capacitors, which are all fairly easy to do. That's better. Better than R8. Right. Now, time for C2. Over there. Let me flow a bit of fresh solder on there. And C2, let me look at the image. Ah, found it. C2 is at the bottom left. It is 105. So, 105 is on here. Let me get that in. Probably not in focus, but here we are. Right, C2 done. Let's do R9 over here. And R9, looking at the image, is 4R7, that's this large unit again. Now it has fallen on its back, so I will have to rotate it. And rotating such a small part is very hard, so I'm just dropping them again until it is falling the correct way, like this. Alright, R10, looking at the image again, R10 is at the bottom right, and it's 3.3 kilo ohms, so let's see, what do I have here. Let's get a bit of light again. It's marked 332, so 3, 3, and then add 2 zeros, which makes 3,300 ohms. Like I said, trying to rotate it is impossible. There we go. Alright, now let's continue with capacitor 9. Capacitor 9 is also at the bottom right of the image, and it is a 104. 104, I do have the 104s over here. Now it's not sitting in nicely, but it works fine. Capacitor 8, let's just continue straight along this way. Capacitor 8 is next to the capacitor 9 on the image, and it is a 106, and which I believe is this one. Let's see if I can get them out of the package. It's probably within the reach of the camera. R6, and R6 is on the left side of that image. It's a 4R7 again. C6. I believe it's, I saw it just, yeah, it's a 106 on the left side of the image. It's a 106. C1, a little bit more. C1, let's see. C1 is just above that on the left side of the image, and it's also a 106. R1, and R1 is on the left side of the same image, 4R7 again. There we go. Right, there's a whole bunch over here, so let me tin all the pads first. Right, let's start over here, R3. And R3 is on the top right of the image, 22 kilo ohms. There it is, 2, 2, 3, so 2, 2, and then add 3 zeros, which makes, now I'm forgetting which one it was, the top one, 22 kilo ohms. I was double checking because I forgot which way I would start, but it was the top one, of course, so R3, there we are. Now C3 is probably within the range, but it is not. So next to it, no. C3. Ah, C3 is on the bottom and middle, and it's a 105. C4, now that's not an explosive, but it's a capacitor, and C4 is also a 105. So there we are. R2, and R2 is on the right side, part 8 they call it, an image, it is in portrait, and it's displayed as portrait vertically, and that's the word I was looking for, and it's a 1K resistor, so 1K, and it's yeah, let's see, probably this one. There we go, 102, there it is. So 100, the microphone is getting probably within the reach of the camera, it just fell down. I'm gonna pause video and fix it. There you can see it dangling over there. I'm gonna fix it one moment. So let's continue. There we are. C5 is on the top right of the image, and it is a 104. Now I found it. It was hidden in plain sight. Oops. Alright, and then R5. R5 is on the top right of the image. It is a 6.2 kilo ohm resistor, which I believe are these. Oh, now my screen turns off. No, these are incorrect. So this one, 6.2 kilo ohms. 622, yeah, so that's 6.2 kilo ohms. It's in the correct position, but I can probably not grip it like that. Now I can, probably. And then the last resistor is a R4, and my guess would be this one, which is 3.2 kilo ohms, but I must look it up, of course, because it can also be this one. So let's see, R4 is over where? It is also on the top right. It's also, it is a 3.3 kilo ohm, so I was right. So let's, there it is. So these are spares, and we do have 6 of them left. So you can try them out over there if you want to practice soldering SMD components. Or you can use one of all the other components, because there's a spare for every component on this kit. So that is nice. Except for that, all the other components. Oh, that's only for capacitors and resistors, of course. Excuse me. Now, let's see what to do next. Let's do this one. It's the USB power input probably. There we go. It is sitting in a correct position like this, I think. It is, because yeah, there are two pins, which makes this thing fit right on there. So that's nice. Now, what I'm going to try to flow some solder on here. Which worked fine. I'm gonna try to flow some solder on there, which also worked fine. Now there are two pins soldered on the right pad, and I don't know if you can see that. So I will not be sticking this into my computer. No way. So that is under. What do we have? A capacitor, longer lead is the positive, so that goes on there. But that's a through-hole component, and I will wait with that, because now it is lying flat on my desk, which is very nice for all the SMD components I have left. And if it was sticking through, it won't be lying flat anymore. So let's do this one first. It's also held in place by something. Two pins, yeah, nice, nice, very nice. It's not a bad kit so far, except for the missing manual part, but right, that's better. All right, so that's on there. And this large unit is also SMD, the large USB connector, also held in place by some notches. Very nice. I'm gonna start with this pin, because this will probably not heat up very much, and if I would start with that one, that would heat the entire case. It needs to heat the entire case, because otherwise the solder won't flow. So I'm gonna do that later on. First do the pins. And now do this. This will probably need some heat. And a fair amount of solder. It's making all squeaky noises, but it is on there. All right. Then the last SMD components are these three tactile switches on this side. Let's use the same technique as it did with the resistors and the capacitors. Let me see. Right. That's no, not good enough. Next tactile switch. Let me get both of them already. Now, let's do this one. First one side, then see if it is sitting in nicely. It is not. No, that needs to be better. Now this will have to do. It is looking just fine. And since I've reflowed this a couple of times, I'm gonna reflow it again. Looking for this one. Which leaves one component on this side. I'm going to do the exact same thing, just flow one pad and wait until it is in the great angle. Oh, let me see, is this nice? Look, is this looking nice? Nice enough. And there I have a LED. And I have a position over there. Would that be the LED? Let me see if I can find a picture of this kit. Let's go to eBay. One moment. Right, I found it, and it is not this one because there are two more holes over there. It's also G1. So let's see. It needs to be in this position, I guess, because there's the line. There's a small diode marking on there, and the line of the diode is on that side, which is the negative. So this will be the position in which the LED needs to go. Well, why not leave it in like that? That is nice. Alright, so that one is probably input voltage, that one, which will probably be the same. So then we have this thing, this huge thing on the back. So now it is held in place. Let's see. All right. Now let's fix all the pins. Alright, now that is done, so let's see if it works. Right, there we go. Here is an SD card with some songs on there. Here are the two plastic speakers I built in the previous video. They're turned on, that's great. Let's plug these speakers in. And that's a little bit too loud. Shut up. What is the volume? There we go. Works perfectly. Doesn't sound bad, so let's try next song. Yeah. What does that do? Pause. Oh, pause play. All right. Yeah. So that works nice. Nice kit. Fun if you want to learn. But what do we see here? I would say fun if you want to learn solder SMD components. So now turning it off is not the fault of this kit. It's just because this power bank, it doesn't detect any power drawn anymore, so it turns off. Right, what would this? Yeah, works perfectly. Pause, play, yeah. Next song. Mute. Power. So yeah, even the remote works. I don't know why, but I really do like this kit so far. It's just for the $3 or so it cost. Yeah, very nice. So thanks for watching.